Sapne prabodhavata. What is waking in the dream state? In the dream also the fellow is sleeping and still he is acting. So he is performing actions like a waker. That is his waking. Sapna jagrat tatharuvam swapna swapnatmakotraya. Then the dream also the fellow dreams. That's the dream of the dream state. Drishtvabhiyat samakhyatam prabuddho neva shaknuyat tadrak swapna sushuptam syat. And then in the dream also he sees a lot of things. But when he wakes up, he can't relate anything. That means the dream also he was sleeping. Even when things are going on, he was sleeping. Otherwise he would have been able to relate when he wakes up in the morning. So that is a sleep in the dream state. Sushuptam chatridhochyate. The deep sleep state also is threefold. Sushupta jagran muhurasyat. Shantoso sapnochyate. Sushupta jagrat. What is sushupta jagrat? Waking in the deep sleep is what? Moodasyat. That the fellow is mood. That is his waking. Shanta. That is his sapna. Aikatma tattva asambodha. And that he is unaware of these experience of non-dual reality. That is asleep in the sleep. That's how Vartikara said, in each of the three states, each of the three things are there. That is why na kanchana kamam kamayate, na kanchana swapnam pashyati. This additional description of visheshanas had to be added to suptaha in order to deny the waking and the dream that takes place in all kinds of avasthas. So that's what Vartika says here. So going back now to page 1089, suptaha, second verse, esurushu avasthasu samanyena yataha sin visrushu avasthasu samanyena suptaha vaya suptaha. So when sutiya yatra suptaha, when a person is sleeping, now you don't know he's sleeping in which state. Whether this sleep means sleeping in the waking or sleeping in the dream or sleeping in the sleep. So yataha since samanyena suptaha visrushu avasthasu. See, this fellow is sleeping. So sleep is common in all the three states. Therefore, which sleep is meant here? Tataha. Vishnasti. Therefore, Shruti qualifies here. Atmaha swapam. Therefore, the swapa, the sleep that the atma has in that particular state, is qualified by Shruti. How? Yatra supta jira sputam. So yatra supta, you know, that way. Yatra supta na kanchana kamam kamayate. So, Sputam, by gira, by those words, sputam vishnasti, how atma, particular kind of sleep that is meant here, is what is clearly stated by the Shruti.
When the Shruti says, yatra suptaha na kanchana kamam kamayate na kanchana svapnam pashyati.
The particular kind of sleep the Shruti means, not just a sleep that occurs in every state, but the particular kind of sleep. Therefore, even the sleep also is qualified by these two qualifications. That is what the Tika says there. Pratyekam
avasthanam.
Pratyekam, it is all pratyekam. Pratyekam actually. Pratyekam avasthanam.
Pravidya uttehe.
So you are able to find it anyway. That's good part. That's an accomplishment that you can find this thing, you know. So pratyekam avasthanam pravidya upte. So in every state, so it was said how every state is characterized by all the threefold states, pravidya upte. Samanyena atma avasthatrayavi supto vartate. The Tikakara explains what we just read, that atma is found to be sleeping in each of the three states. Tasmat yatra supta hedi uptam atma swapam. Therefore, yatra suptaha, that way the swapa is being said, the sleep is said. Na kanchanitya adhigira,
pashtikrutya,
vishinasti is futa. So, na kanchanitya adhigira, na kanchana kamam
kamayate, by those words,
then Shruti wants to very clearly state the kind of sleep that is meant, and not the sleep that is generally meant in all the three states. Then Tika continues. Astu atma swapasya idam visheshanam. All right. So this is visheshanam of atma swapa.
of the sleeve of the Atma, this is a Visheshanam, na kanchana kamam kamayate, na kanchana svapnam pashyastu. Let it be so. Tathabi, tena, kamasteva nishedat. But in the deep sleep state, the sleep that is meant here, the Shruti is only negating kama and svapna. How do you say jagra svapna nishedakrat? So Vartikara said that this particular Visheshanam, meaning this particular qualification, that he doesn't have any kama, nor does he see any dream, by these two, the Jagrat and Swapna are meant to be negated. How? The Shruti merely negates kama, doesn't negate Jagrat. Kathapi tena kamasyeva nishedat. Only kama is negated, that it is not there. Jagrat Swapna nishedakrati ayuktam. Iti ayuktam. So for you to say that, Shruti negates the waking in the dream, so dream is all right, because na kanchana svapnam pashyati. But Shruti doesn't say that there is no jagrat there, it only says na kanchana kamam kamayate. So how to equate that with the negation of the waking state? That is the idea here. Ityaha na ityadina, so then the third verse is that. Na kanchane idi kamoyaha svapna jagradavasthayoho nisiddhyate susuptyesav tatha svapno biyastayoho na kanchana kamam kamayate idi yaha kamaha svapna jagradavasthayoho yaha kamaha asav susupte nisiddhyate. So why the word kama? The Shruti wants to deny the kama that obtains both in the waking as well as the dream states, because in both the states kama or the desire obtains. So the tika avasthadvayasya kama matrasya so avasthadvayasya kama matrasya swape nishehat avasthadvayapi tatra nishidhyate. Because kama is a characteristic of waking as well as characteristic of dream, and therefore by denying the kama, which is the principal characteristic of waking and also the characteristic of dream, the Shruti actually denies the waking as well as dream by the denial of kama. What happens is, if only waking was denied, then the kama of the dream would not have been denied. But by using the word kama, not only kama obtaining in the waking, but the kama obtaining the dream also is meant to be denied. And that is how both the avasthas are denied by the use of the word kama. All right. Idi chet. Visheshanantra anarthakyam. All right. If this does by the word kama, both the waking and dream states are denied, then na kanchana svapnam pashyati. Then why should you have to say that he does not see any dream? Because according to you, the dream also is denied by the use of word kama. Tatha. Then Vartikar said, tatha svapnopi yastayoho. Tatha yastayoho svapna jagadavastayoho svapna. So, sopi nishidhyate. Tatha similarly, so tayoho, just as the kama obtaining in the waking a dream is denied, so also the svapna obtaining in the waking dream also is denied. So in the waking and dream, not only there is kama, but there is svapna also. As we saw, in every state there is everything. So that is also denied, tayoho. This is tika, svapna jagayoho svapna. Susupte dvitiyena visheshena nishidhyate. Svapna jagrayoho svapna. The dream of being and waking in the dream is denied or negated by the second visheshana na kanchana svapnam pashyati. Tena tadapi adya visheshanavat arthavat eva. And therefore, since in the waking and dream both kama also are there and svapna also is there, therefore both the visheshana are required to completely deny both the states in that particular thanam, or that particular antam. Purvatra kama pradhanyena avasthadvaya nishedha, uttaratra svapma pradhanyena di bhavaha. The idea is that na kanchana kamam kamayate, there also there is denial of waking in the dream, but that is characterized by tama. And na kanchana svapnam pashyati, by that also there is denial of waking in dream, characterized by dream. So, in one, kama pradhanyena, svapna pradhanyena. So waking where kama is pradhana, that is denied. Waking where svapna is pradhanam, that is also denied. Dream where kama is pradhanam, that is denied. Dream when Sopna is Karanam, there is both, both are there. And therefore, both are denied by this.
So this is how the two Visheshanas are denied. Now,
Adya Visheshanasya Arthantramaha Na Kanchana Kamam Kamayate. There is Arthantram, another Artha. Another Prayojanam, another purpose also
is served by that Visheshanam
where Vartikara Sopna Vayate. Svapneva kama virahar yathoktene vartvana jagrat kama nishedotah tatra kama adi sambhavat. But then in svapna there is no, so svapneva kama virahar,
there is no kama in the dream.
Asangoyem purushah ananvagadastena bhavati. So Shruti denies even the kama in the dream earlier. Svapneva kama virahar. So really desire is there only in the waking. Kartrutva is there only in the waking. In the dream there is only bhoktrutva. Therefore there is no new kama or the desire. If suppose that is what you say, then
svapneva kama virahat.
Oh, let us put it this way. The na kanchana kamam kamayate, that visheshanam may have this purpose to serve. Alternate position is va svapne kama virahat. Since there is absence of kama or the desire in the dream, by the vartma, meaning by the method that we have already stated, jagrat kama nishedah, then we can say that when kama is denied, only jagrat kama, the waking kama is denied. Ataha tatra kama adi sambhavad, because in the waking alone, the kama is there in the primary sense.
Then we can say that
na kanchana kama kamayate denies the waking only. So yathokta ne vartmano,
yathokta
asangohi di uktamargena di avata. So asangohayam purusha, in where the discussion was there, how there is no kama or the desire in the dream state. Asanganyayena jagardabhi ragadirahityam tulhyam. Asangohayam purusha, since the purusha is unattached, therefore
there is no desire in the dream state. Somebody says there is no desire in the waking also, because atma is asanga anyway. And therefore, even desiring also is not done in the Atma, because Atma is asanga.
Asangatva nyayena. If because of asangatva, because Atma is asanga unattached, therefore you say that there is no kama in the dream state, then Atma is asanga in the waking also, there is no kama really in the waking also. Asangatva nyayena jagardyabhi ragadirahityam tulyam. Therefore, in the waking state also, the absence of raga dvesha is tulya, is of the same as in the dream. Iti asangya tatra iti. Then Vartekara said, tatra kamasya sambhava, tatra kamadi sambhava. In the waking, the kama is supposed to be, why? Sati matari bhada vidurah jagrati kamadihi svapnetu naiva mityartha. It is true that for the Atma there is no kama. But at least in the waking state there is pramata, there is knower, there is doer. So at least there is a karta, the kartrutvam is there in the waking state.
That kartrutva is not there in the dream state also.
So in that sense we say that
at least in the waking state there is this desire, because the pramata, the knower is there, the doer also is there. So sati madri madri pramadri bada vidurah. Jagrati kamadihi bada vidurah.
So inasmuch as in the waking state the pramata is there, therefore the kama is even no fault. In the waking state also, really, there is no kama or the desire for the Atma, but that is not known. Inasmuch as one takes oneself to be pramata or the knower, so long the kama or the desire is real, in that sense we say that in the waking state the desire is there.
But for that fear also, even for this pramada, there is no desire in the dream. Because when he wakes up from the dream, then he knows that all the dream was false.
So even this pramada himself knows so. As far as the kama is of the dream is concerned, the bada is there. So when I am dreaming, of course, I feel that I am desiring that. But when I wake up from the dream, then I know that the kama or the desire in the dream was false. That means that in my own experience, there is a bada or the negation of the desires in the dream. But in my experience, there is no negation of desire in waking. So unless paramarthikam jnanam takes place, this waking kama cannot be negated. But the Vyavaharic Jnana also, every day I keep on negating the dream karma, then we can say that there is no karma in the dream, I know that. But I do not know is that there is no karma in the waking. And therefore, why the word karma? Primarily, what is meant is karma obtaining in the waking state. Svapne tu naivam. But in svapna, that karma is negated when I wake up. Therefore, we know that the karma obtaining in the dream is not the same degree of reality as karma obtaining in the waking. So, karma obtaining in dream is pratibhasika. Karma obtaining in the waking is vyavaharika. So, pratibhasika is denied. Vyavaharika is not there until knowledge takes place. So therefore, until then, this karma is there. So it is accepted. So that is how, na kanchana kamam kamayate, you may say that the Shruti intends to deny the karma or the desire in the waking state. And that way, the waking state is meant to be denied by this expression, na kanchana kamam kamayate. Then the Tikakara says, dvitiya visheshanasya arthantaramaha. Na kanchana svapnam pasyati, does not see any dream. That's the dvitiya visheshan, the second qualification. Arthantarama. What's the artha? So what is the another meaning of that also is stated. Ekaikasyamiti. Then, going back to the verse. Ekaikasyam avasthayam jagra svapna sushuptibhi yadiva vidyate bhedaha kanchaneti cha lingataha. Ekaikasyam avasthayam, in every state, in each one of the states, svapneva, jagra svapna susupti vihi, so yadiva vidyate bhedaha, ekaikasyam avasthayam jagra svapna susupti vihi bhedaha vidyate, yadiva, or if we accept this way, then each one of the states, waking, dream and deep sleeps, that there, the jagra svapna susupta obtains in each one of them, then this is what? Ya vidyate. So we have to say that kanchana iti lingataha. See, the Shruti denies any kind of a dream. Na kanchana svapnam pasyati, that it does not see any kind of a dream. That means that different kinds of dreams are there. Therefore, Vartikara says that by the linga, by the use of this word kanchana, Shruti means to say that different kinds of dreams are there. That there is dream not only in the dream state, but in the waking and sleep also, that there are dreams. And this is what we arrive at by the use of the word kanchana. That's what Bhashyakara said. Bhashyakara said it slightly differently. Vartikara says it somewhat differently. Bhashyakara said that Shruti means that the whole waking is dream. Vartikara said in the dream, in the waking there is dream, in the dream there is dream. That. So this is quite a unique contribution of Vartikara. We don't see it quite by Bhashyakara. But Vartikara has contributed this saying that in every state there is every state. So this is very popular with Mahatmas. They will say all of this, you know. Ram, Lakshmana, Bharata, Shatrughna, you know, these four brothers talk about the four states. Everybody says in their own way, but anyway, Rama is a Turiya, that's for sure. Now who else is there? So you can interpret however you like. And so Lakshmana is Jagrat Vibhu. Lakshmana is a Virat. And then Shatrughna is the deep sleep state. And Bharata is Hiranyagarbha or something like that, you know. So this is how these three, and the Rama, Rama then is the Turiya. And Fir Kahenge, then they will all elaborate. So the Jagrat may be Jagrat hai, Swapna hai, Sushupti hai, Ye hai, Turiya, sab mein sab kuch hota hai. And that's how they'll keep on, you know, spinning the web. But anyway, so all of that comes from here. It's nice, you know. So it's nice to dwell upon these things because these kind of states are there. It's a further analysis of what we call waking. That we just lump the whole experience of waking as waking. On the other hand, that waking also can be further analyzed and dwelt upon, and we can see the shades of difference obtaining the waking, shades of difference obtaining the dream, which is okay. But I don't think that is what Bhashyakara meant. Bhashyakara just meant that na kanchana svapnam. So, that does not see any kind of a dream, meaning therefore, the Shruti believes that waking also is a kind of dream. And in consistence with this, Bhashyakara explained in the Mandukya Upanishad, where this vakya appears, yatra suptaha, where suptaha was interpreted as the one who is ignorant. So,
So one is sleeping to the reality of one's own self. Anadi maya suptaha. So that's suptaha. Na kanchana kamam kamayate. So where the ignorant person does not see any doesn't desire any desirable objects, where the ignorant person does not see any dreams. So that is the state of deep sleep. That is how Bhashyakara explained that. Here, however, Vartikara says, na kanchana, no kind of a dream. That means that different kinds of dreams, dream obtaining in waking, dream obtaining in dream, and dream obtaining in deep sleep state. So this is what we presume. So from the use of the word, the fact that the Shruti uses the word kanchana, therefore we infer from here, we presume the Shruti means that there are dreams in every state. Tikagara says, na kanchana swapnam pasyati tatra kanchanidi bheda dyoti visheshanad. Kanchana means of no kind. That means bheda, different kinds are meant there. Yukta bheda, so bheda visheshanad, ukta bheda siddhihi. Therefore, the bheda, the kind of differences that we have stated. So, bheda means that different kinds of dreams are there in the waking dream and the deep sleep, siddhihi. So, from the use of the word kanchana, what we said earlier, that in all the three states, there are three states, is in fact concurred by the Shruti, by the use of the word kanchana, because Shruti means that different kinds of dreams are there, and different kinds of dreams means dreams obtaining different states. Then says the Tika, avasthanam pratyekam traividya sadhakam vakyantaram chasti. Avasthanam pratyekam traividya sadhakam. That every avastha has these threefold avasthas, vakyantaram chasti, then another vakya also is there. Tasya traya avastha, as Bhashyakara quoted, that vakya also. So Vartikara says, tasya traya avasthaha, traya svapnaha. That vakya says how in each state there are three states, you know. So avasthanam pratyekam traividya sadhakam. Pratyek avastha is traividya, threefoldness is there. So that is how that vakya is interpreted by Vartikara traya haiti. So Vartika says traya avastha iti tathacha shruti shasanam jagrat svapna susuptanam traividya pratipadakam. So traya avasataha tatra tasya traya avasataha traya svapnaha iti. So by that tathacha shruti shasanam, so that's a declaration of the Shruti. That shasanam, that declaration of Shruti, what does it do? Traividya pratipadakam shasanam. That shasanam or declaration of Shruti, in fact traividya pratipadakam, the definite delineates that there is a threefold states. Why? Jagrat Svapna Sushuptanam. In all the three states, there are these three states are there. See, tasya traya avasataha. Avastha means sthanani. And traya svapnaha. That means there are three kinds of dreams in each three kinds of avasthas. Traya avasataha. Avastha means sthanani. That is three states. And traya svapnaha. And three dreams. That means that in every state there is a dream. So that is how Vartikara says that this vakya can be interpreted to mean that in every state all the three states are there. Okay. Siddhe traividhye kim prakrute siddhyati. Alright. You have now established that in each of the three states there are three states. Okay. Siddhe traividhye kim prakrute siddhyati. So what relevance does it have with reference to what we are discussing? Na kanchana kamam kamayate, na kanchana svapnam pasyati. So you are in the process of explaining the purpose of these qualifications, visheshana on the part of the Shruti. So kim atra siddhati. So what does this threefold states, you know, have to do with this? Then Vartikara says tatra iti, the next verse. Tatra trayanam sthananam jagra svapna nishedhanam. So na kanchana svapnam pasyati, na kanchana kamam kamayate. So by kama is negated the waking state. Na kanchana svapnam pasyati, by the word svapna is negated the dream state. Which waking state? The waking in all the three states is negated, and the dream in all the three states is negated. So na kanchana kamam kamayate, he does not have any kind of a desire. So desire of praying in the waking, desire of praying in the dream, or desire of praying in deep sleep, that is waking obtaining in the waking, waking obtaining in the dream, and waking obtaining deep sleep, all these three kinds of waking are negated by the kama. Na kanchana svapnam pashyati, and by this word svapna, each kind of svapna in the waking, dream and deep sleep is meant to be denied. Tatra trayanam sthananam jaga svapna nishedanam na kanchanati vakyena. By that vakya, all jagrat and svapna obtaining in all the three states are meant to be negated. That's what Tika says. The page 1091. Sthananam trayanam pratyekam trevidya siddhe. So in each sthana, in each state, there's this threefoldness is being established, having been established. Trividasya jagrasya adhyena. All the three kinds of waking is meant to be denied by na kanchana kamam kamayate. Trividasya cha svapnasya dvitiyena visheshanena nishedha siddhyate. And that na kanchana svapnam pashyati, by that all the three dreams obtaining the three states are meant to be denied. Ityatha. Why do you say that? Tatra hetuhu. How do you say that? Tayoho. So then Vartika said, tayoreva graha shrutehe. Tayoho eva graha shrutehe. Tayoho. Tayoho means what? Kama svapna shabdabhyam. Tayoho eva jagra svapna yoho shrutya grahat. So by the word kama and the svapna, shruti means waking and the dream. Tayoho sarva prakaryoho nishedha atra vivakshita, and therefore all the waking and dream, every kind of a waking and every kind of dream is meant to be denied in this particular state. So that's a real deep sleep, you know. So deep sleep. Because the sleep also, even though when he's not dreaming, then what do you call it? Rapid eye movement, all kinds of things are there. So the sleep also has different states. Then it goes back and comes and, you know. But then, where no dream and no desire obtains, that sleep is what is meant by the anta. So that is what is meant here. Where there is total freedom from any kind of a desire. Antaral avastha is also not. No avastha is there. No kind of activity. I guess when they take all these different current, alpha waves and whatever waves and beta waves and so forth, then they'll find that's a state where no activity whatever is there. Total prashanti. So total repose is there. It's not very, very common. But then that may happen now and then for a person. So even when we are sleeping, we're not quite sleeping. But then when you're sleeping. So when the mind is totally in repose, that is the state that is meant by the Shruti. Yatra supto na kanchana kamam kamayate na kanchana svapnam pashyati. Now you don't have to turn the pages back and forth. Now you're on the page. So 1090, the first line. In case you keep turning, that's why I have to tell you, no? So no more turn the pages. Okay. Then Tikagara says, Visheshana Dvayartham Anuvadati. Alright, so Visheshana Dvayartham. These two Visheshanas, the artha, the purpose that they serve, the meaning that they impart, Anuvadati, reiterates Swapnamiti. Swapnam Nakanchane Tyuktya Sarva Swapna Nishedanam. In short, Vartikara himself says that. Swapnam Nakanchane Tyuktya Nakanchana Swapnam Pashyati. By that statement, sarva svapna nishedanam, there is a nisheda or denial of any kind of a dream at that time. And then says the Tikakara, kamam na kanchanityuktya sarva jagra nishedanam. That also you must understand. Kamam na kanchanityuktya sarva jagra nishedanam. Na kanchana kamam kamayate, by that, all kinds of jagrat also is negated. Iti api dashtavyam. That line also you must see as being there. So kamam na kanchanetyuktya duktya sarva jagra nishedanam, svapnam na kanchanetyuktya sarva svapna nishedanam. So every kind of waking, every kind of dream is denied. Alright, tathavi prakrite kim siddhyati. Alright, suppose every kind of waking and every kind of dream is denied here, then also in this particular matter and the discussion, kim siddhyati. So what is it that it amounts to? इति प्रबोधे इति प्रबोध स्वप्नाभ्याम विविक्तम स्थानम उच्यते. इन दिस मैनर प्रबोध स्वप्नाभ्याम वेकिंग एंड ड्रीम सो विविक्तम स्थानम उच्यते. दिस इज अनंत दैट इज टोटली डिस्टिंक्ट फ्रॉम द वेकिंग एंड द ड्रीम. Where waking and dream, there is no mixture of waking and dream of any kind. That is the sthanam that is meant here by the word anta. So this is all the two visheshanas, two qualifications. Na kanchana kamam kamayate, na kanchana swapnam pashyati. This is a qualification of yatra supta. So a supta is characterized by this. So Vartikara says, that what it amounts to is that every kind of waking and every kind of dream is totally denied. It is that state which is devoid of any disturbances obtained in the waking and the dream. Then says Tikakara, Visheshanartha Muktva Antaya Dhavati Tyasyartha Upasamharati Antaya Dhavati Yatra Supto Na Kanchana Kamam So Etasmai Antaya Dhavati Evamevayam Purusha Etasmai Antaya Dhavati. In a manner similar to that, this Purusha, the Atma, runs towards the anta of the abode. So, Visheshanartha Muktva, first of all, Na Kanchana Kama Kamayate, Na Kanchana Swapnam Pashyati, that Visheshana, the meaning of those Visheshanas are said, and now, Antaya Dhavaditya Asyartham Upasamharati, and then the meaning of Antaya Dhavati, he runs for that end, is concluded Jagratati. So, the verse says, Jagrat Swapnatmaka Upakshav, वितत्यात्मात्ममोहवान् भुक्त्वा भोगान्तः श्रान्तः पक्षौ संहृत्य चात्मनि. सो टू दिस बर्ड हैज टू विंग्स जागृत स्वप्नात्मको पक्षौ. ही कीप्स ऑन फ्लैपिंग द विंग्स, यू नो दैट हॉक और द फाल्कन कीप्स ऑन फ्लैपिंग द विंग्स होल डे एंड दैट्स हाउ ही गेट्स एग्जॉस्टेड फटीग्ड. So also the Atma keeps on flapping the wings, waking and dream, keeps on flapping those wings. So Jagrat Swapnatmaka Upakshu, his two wings of the nature of waking and the dream, Vitatya, Atma, Atma Mohavan, Bhuktva Bhogan. So Atma Mohavan, Atma, Jagrat Swapnatmaka Upakshu, Vitatya, Bhogan, Bhuktva. So spreading, or Vitatya, Vitatya means spreading also. So spreading or using his wings of the nature of waking in the dream, Atma Mohavan, the Atma who is ignorant of his true nature, Bhogan Bhunte, so Bhogan Bhuktva. He experiences various kinds of pleasures or gains various experiences in the waking and dream states on account of his ignorance. Atha Shrantah, then being exhausted, fatigued, Pakshav Samrutya, then he folds up, he stops flapping his wings and he folds up his wings. Samhrutya, Samhrutya cha atmani, both the paksha, the wings of the nature of waking and dream, both of them are now folded up or withdrawn into his own self. Tika says, anta shabda vachya brahma nidartham gachyati visheshah. So, shrantah pakshav samhrutya cha atmani. Thus, withdrawing both these states or both these wings into himself, anta shabda vachya brahma nidartham gachyati, and then he goes to this brahma nida, to goes to his own abode, which is brahma, which is what is meant by the word anta, anta shabda vachya. So the vachyartha, what is meant by the word anta vada shruti is brahma, and that is what the nida, that's the nest, and that's where the atma goes. Having folded up his wings, he goes there. Then, Shrantasya Ashray Gaman Apeksha Dyotanartha Atha Shabdaha. Then the verse, Bhuktva Bhogan Atha Shrantaha. That word Atha. Atha means then. So, Shrantasya Ashray Gaman Apeksha. It is a common experience that whenever somebody is tired, then there is always a desire to take rest, go to an abode or go to a resting place. So a person, when he gets tired, there is always a desire to go to a resting place. So similarly also the Atma is tired, so there is a desire to go to a resting place, which is this anta here. Then, Tika says, संहत्य पक्ष दुष्टांतेन दाष्टांतिके विवक्षितम अंशमाह। दुष्टांत दाष्टांत विवक्षित अंश, संहत्य पक्ष दुष्टांतेन दैट ही स्ट्रेचेस हिज विंग्स एंड देन ही रिपेयर्स बैक टू हिज नेस्ट दैट बर्ड। दाष्टांतिके व्हाट इज द इंप्लिकेशन इन द दाष्टांत, सो विवक्षितम अंशम, अंश द पोर्शन दैट इज meant here from Dushtanta is being said by the Vartikara Avidyayamati. As Bhashyakara also said, so here Vartikara also Avidyayamati. Avidyayam avasthanam tadudbhutasya vastunah samhyatya pakshopamaya shrutyeha pratipadyade. So Vartikara has a lot to say about that, you know. Then he folds up his wings unto himself. Says Avidyayam avasthanam. Then this avasthanam or this remaining now in the sleep is in the state of ignorance. Avidyayam avasthanam tat udbhutasya vastunah. From the avidya the whole universe is created. And he folded the whole universe into ignorance at that time. So whole universe is folded up in the causal state is ignorance. Tat udbhutasya vastunah samhatya paksha upamaya. So that he stretches his wings. That means now he folds everything unto himself. So by that upama, by that comparison, by the dushtanta, what is meant is that everything, the whole waking and the dream worlds are folded up into ignorance, which is the cause. Shrutya iha pratipadyate. In this vakya, this is what the shruti means to delineate. Says the tika, pakshau samhatya swatmaneva sankuchitau avayav apadye. What is meant by paksho samhatya? Stretching his wings. What is that? Svatmaneva sankuchitav avayav apadye. So, all the avayava, you know, sankuchita avayava. This avayava means his limbs, all of them are, he actually folds up in himself. That is what is meant. So, when a person wants to rest, what he does is, he folds up all his activities, the bird also folds up his activity in the sense of his wings also are now folded up when he goes into the nest anyway. Svashre shramadhumsatam shenaha tishthati. So when he comes to the nest, then he folds up his wings into himself and shramadhumsatam for dhumsa, for the elimination of that exhaustion or fatigue, shenaha tishthati. So now we are talking about the state of the shena, of that hawk or falcon, when he is in his nest, how he has folded up his wings, and now he reposes for the rest in order to become free from the exertion. Iti dushtanta shrutya, so this is a dushtanta. Sabhasayam avidyayam jagataha avasthanam vivakshitam. So similarly also, avidyayam avasthanam tadudbhutasya vastunah. That means avidya avidyodbhutastha vastunah. The vastu or the whole universe that is created from avidya, all of that goes back into avidya in that state. So avidya avasthanam. So atma, who has spread himself as the whole universe, you can say. So not only that is his individual waking in the dream, but you can say that same Paramatma has now stretched himself, spread himself as a whole waking. So as Virat, as well as Hiranyagarbha. So as a samashti waking and samashti dream, he folds up everything in this state of deep sleep. That also can be said. Sabhasayam avidyayam jagatah avasthanam vivakshitam. That the whole universe now remains in its native state, in the causal state, in the ignorance, which enjoys a reflection of consciousness. Always, wherever ignorance is there, the reflection of consciousness will be there. Wherever water is, sun is shining, and the water is there in the front of it, that there will be reflection. Sahaja tadatma is there. Similarly also, it is the nature of avidya to reflect consciousness. Sahaja tadatma. Therefore, the subtle body that is born of avidya also reflects consciousness. And therefore, gross body also reflects consciousness. Everything reflects consciousness that is born of avidya in its own way. The extent of reflection of consciousness varies, but everything reflects consciousness because the very cause, avidya, reflects the consciousness. So they keep repeating, sabhasayam avidyayam avajagatah avasthanam vivakshitam. So avidya which enjoy the reflection of consciousness, in that the whole jagat has its abode in the causal state. Iha avidya avisambandha shrutya iha pratipadyate. Wow. Samhatya pakshopamaya shrutya iha pratipadyate. So iha is, so avidya, avidyayam pratipadyate, whatever. No, sorry. Iha avidyayam. That's how. Iha avidyayam avasthanam. That is how this sambandha is. Iha avidyayam iti sambandha. Iha also is seventh case. Avidyayam also is seventh case. Iha avidyayam. Here, in the ignorance, the whole universe comes to in its causal state. That is what is meant by the Shruti. Then, tika se sanlaya drishtantena darshtandike vivakshitam arthamaha. Okay, I think that will continue tomorrow better. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. 8. Tadithyasminna kashe shenova suparnova. Viparipatya shranta samhatya pakshau. Sanlalaya eva dhriyate. Eva mevayam purushah. Etasma antaya dhavate. Yatta supto na kanchana kamam kamayate. Na kanchana svapnam pashyate. We are discussing the Karoda Patra, page 1089. Anta Shabda Vakyasya Visheshanam. So first of all, Vatikara explained, Suptaha. This Anta, Evameva Ayam Purushaha, Etasmi Antaya Dhavati. Just as Shena or a Suparna in the evening, being fatigued, then, in order to gain rest or becoming free from that fatigue or exertion, stretches its wings, goes to the nest, and then rests in the nest. Similarly also this person, having undergone a great exertion during the waking and the dream states, and then runs towards that state, etasmi antaya dhavati, he runs for that anta. What is this anta? This anta itself is described or qualified as, so yatra supto na kanchana kamam kamayate na kanchana svapnam pashyate. Yatra, where supta, the sleeping person, na kanchana kamam kamayate, does not entertain any desire, that means does not desire any desirable objects, na kanchana svapnam pashyate, where he does not dream. So this is how the anta is described. This anta is nothing but ajnatam brahma. What Vartikara means to say is, etasmi antaya dhavati, he runs towards this anta. Anta means can be the end, can be the state, can be the abode. Here it means Brahma, but ajnatam Brahma. Brahma is enveloped in ignorance, but Brahma nevertheless. That Brahman alone is being described here. सुप्तः यत्र न कंचन कामं कामयते न कंचन स्वप्नं पश्यति. इन दैट स्टेट, स्टेट ऑफ टोटल डीप स्लीप, वेयर ऑल देयर इज ब्रह्मन, सो इट इज सुप्तः इज अ डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द डीप स्लीप. And the deep sleep is described as, by qualifying it, as absence of kama and absence of swapna. So, how come? The question is, so the Bhashyakara, Vartikara says, yatra suptona kamiti jagra swapna nishedakrut visheshanam. This visheshanam, that there is an absence of kama and absence of swapna, so kama eliminates jagrat and swapna eliminates dream. So how do you say that kama eliminates jagrat? Kama eliminates kama. Says yes, but jagrat is characterized by kama. And so swapna obtaining in both waking and dream. Na kanchana idi kamo yaha swapna jagrat avasthayo nishidhyate. That na kanchana kamam, that none, no desire whatever. So because of that kanchana word, asau tatha swapne bhi, and so swapna jagrat avasthayo kamaha nishidhyate. Therefore desire in both swapna and jagrat, because desires obtained in every state. Therefore, at least in two states, waking and dream states, and therefore the desire obtaining in both the states is negated. Tatha svapnebi, svapnobi yastayoho, svapna jagrayoho. Similarly also the dream, obtaining the waking and dream also is sought to be denied by the denial of svapna. Svapneva kama virahat yathoktene vartuna jagrat kam nishedotah tatra kama adisambhavat. Or one may say, that since there is no kama in the dream state, because atma is described as sangha, therefore one may say that the denial of kama is denial of the desire obtaining the waking state, because that is where the desire obtains. Ekikasyam avasthayam jagra svapna sushupti bhi yadi vavidyate bheda kanchanaiti chalingataha. And by this linga, by this use of the word kanchana, no desire whatever, no dream whatever, therefore also we can come to this conclusion. Ekaikasyam avasthayam, that in every state, namely the waking, dream and deep sleep, jagrat svapna sushupti sushupti vedah vidyate. That there is a distinction of jagrat, svapna and sushupti. In each one of this, jagrat, svapna, sushupti. So jagrat, 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 svapna, jagrat, sushupti. Svapna, jagrat, svapna, 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 sushupti. Sushupta jagrat, sushupti jagrat, sushupti swapna, sushupti sushupti, nine avasthas are there. So by the use of word kanchana, no dream whatever, that means there are different kinds of dreams. That means dreams obtain not only in the dream state, but then obtain in the other states also. Tray avasataha iti tatha cha shruti sashasanam. Even Aitreya Shruti also says, asya taya traya avasataha. Traya svapnaha. The three abodes are there and three dreams are there. So three dreams are there, not one dream. And so in every abode there is a dream. And thus that Shruti also seems to confirm that. Jagrat svapna sushuptanam trividhya pratipadakam Shruti shasanam asti. That jagrat svapna sushupti, each one is threefold, so that is delineated by the Shruti. Tatra trayanam sthananam jagrat svapna nishedanam na kanchanadi vakyena tayoreva grahasrutehe. And so, tatta trayanam sthananam jagrat svapna nishedhanam. And therefore, in each of the three states, waking, dream and deep sleep, the jagrat and svapna obtaining in each state is sought to be denied by this na kanchana. Na kanchana svapnam pashyati. Tayoreva grahasrutehe. Because that is shruti, graha. So tayoho jagrat svapnayoho graha. So when Shruti says kanchana svapnam, kanchana kamam, it is meant in waking as well as in dream states. Swapnam na kanchanityuktya. So kama also means both the states. Swapnam kanda kanchanityuktya. Sarvap swapna nishedanam. No dream obtains means no dream in any three states obtains. Similarly, no kama obtains means kama in none of the three states obtains. Idi prabodha swapna bhyam vivittam sthanam uchyate. And therefore, this anta, which is the suptahan, that is the sthanam of the abode, which is totally devoid of any kind of waking or any kind of dream, which is nothing but sleep, sleep. That's what that sthana means. Jagrat svapnātmaka upakshau. So that is how the word anta, which is characterized by these two attributes, was explained. Now, etasmi antaya dhāvati. So what is meant by that? Jagrat svapnātmaka upakshau. Vitatyatmatma mohavan bhuktva bhogan. Jagrat svapnātmaka upakshau vitatya. Chandogya Upanishad also describes it. Like a bird that with a string it is tied to a post. It flies in all directions and finding no resting place comes back to the post. And similarly also this jiva or the atma. So flying around in the waking in the dream states, finding no abode, comes back to the deep sleep state, which is its own nature. Here, in a similar way, although, so here the abode is a nest. There the abode is a place where it is tied. The idea is that the jivatma is always tied to Brahman, is never away from Brahman. Just as the pot is never away from the clay, so also this jivatma, regardless of what he does, in which state he is never away from Brahma, because Brahma is its true nature. And similarly, so here, however, it is the nest that is being described. And so this nest is nothing but Brahman. So here also the nest, the abode, the deep sleep he always wants to come back to, and therefore that nest or that abode is nothing but Brahman, which is his true nature. This is what is meant here. Jagrat svapnātmaka upakshau vitatya atma atma mohavan. And therefore, because of ignorance, vitatya, so spreading his wings, and that means flying in the waking in the dream states, bhogan, bhuktva, and having experienced the various bhoga, or experience in the two states, atha, now there is a need to come back to that abode, shrantaha, pakshau, samhatya, atmane, shrantaha, being fatigued, so pakshau, samhrutya, withdrawing the wings unto himself, Atmani. So, the explanation was given there. So, Anta-shabda-vachya Brahma-nirartham gacchati. Anta-shabda means Brahma. Shrantasya ashraya-gamana-peksha devutanartha-apeksha-devutanartha atha-shabdaha. So that is about the bird, and similar samhatya paksha drushtandena darshtandike vivakshita mumshamaha. On that page 1091, we are in the middle there, in the sixth line from the top. Samhatya paksha drushtandena darshtandike vivakshita mumshamaha. So that he stretches his wings by the drushtanda. Darshtandike, darshtandike is atma. So vivakshitam amshamaha, the amsha, the portion that is desired, so that is to be compared between the sthana and the ashtanta. Vartika said, avidyayam avasthanam tadudbhutasya vastunah samhatya pakshopamaya shrutyeha pratipadyate. So avidyayam avasthanam tadudbhutasya vastunah, that means avidya, avidyodbhutasya vastunah. The whole vastu, meaning the whole universe that is created out of ignorance, all that whole creation finds its resting place in the causal state, in the state of deep sleep. Avidyayam avasthanam. Pakshau samhatya svatmaneva sankuchitavayav apadya svashre shrimadvamsatham shrenihat shtadidhi dhishtanda shrutya. So how, withdrawing all his limbs unto himself, how he rests in his nest. That is drishtanda. Shuddha buddhadiyat praticha rupam. No, where are we? Yeah, okay. Yes. सशुद्ध बुद्धादि यत् प्रतीचः रूपम्। नो दिस इज वेर या साभासम साभासायाम अविद्यायाम जगत अवस्थानम विवक्षितम। सो व्हाट इज इंटेंडेड देयर इज सो दैट इन इग्नोरेंस द होल अवस्था इज साभासायाम। सो इग्नोरेंस that is that enjoys a reflection of consciousness, so that is where the whole universe rests at that time. Iha avidyayam iti sambandha. So that verse we did yesterday, that was the last verse. Iha avidyayam tad udbhutasya vastunah avasthanam. In the state of deep sleep, in the ignorance with the causal state, the whole universe, which is the effect of this ignorance, all of that finds its abode. It's rest, a resting place in the ignorance, in the deep sleep state. Okay, now we continue. Oh, that also we read. Sanlaya drishtantena darshtantike vivakshitam aha. So first of all, stretching his wings and returning to the nest. And what is nest? Nest is sanlaya. Samyak liyate asminiri sanlaya. So where one finds a total cessation of all exertion. So when one is totally absorbed, you know, so that is sanlaya. And that is here, Brahma. So, sanlaya dushtandena darshtandike vivakshitamaha samiti. संहत्य पक्षोपमया न संललायेति यच्छुद्धं रूपं स्यात् प्रत्यगात्मनः प्रत्यक्चिदाभ आगत्य ध्रियते प्रत्यगात्मने। संललाय इति, सो द बर्ड कम्स टू संललाय, दैट इज हिज नेस्ट। इति यच्छुद्धं रूपं स्यात् प्रत्यगात्मनः प्रत्यगात्मनः यच्छुद्धं रूपं स्यात्। So that which is the true nature of Pratyagatma, Shuddha Buddha Mukta Svabhava, Pratyakchidabha Agatya Dhriyate Pratyagatmane. He, the bird, is a Jivatma, who is Pratyakchidabha, who is a Chidabhasa, Agatya. So it is that pure form that is where the Jivatma comes, Pratyagatmane Dhriyate, and then he rests in the Pratyagatma. So that's what the Tika explains. शेनो ही सम्यक् निलयार्थम् स्वनीडाय आत्मानम् धारयति। शेनो ही दैट हॉक और फाल्कन सम्यक् निलयार्थम्। सो दिस इन ऑर्डर फॉर द निलयना, इन ऑर्डर टू फाइंड ए कंप्लीट रेस्ट, स्वनीडाय आत्मानम् धारयति। दैट्स हाउ ही सस्टेन्स हिमसेल्फ इन सो फॉर टुवर्ड्स हिज ओन नेस्ट। Svanidaya, for his nest, Atmanam Dharati. And therefore, in short, he repairs or he proceeds towards his own nest for Samyak Nilayaya, so that he can find a complete rest there, repose. Iti Dushtanda Shrutya. Now see the verse. Shuddha Buddhadiyat Pratichaha Rupam Tad Vivakshitam Syat. That's what he said there. Sanlalaya iti. Sanlalaya iti means what? So, shenohi samyak nilayayantham svadinaya atmanam dharati dushtanda shrutya. That is the whole meaning. That is the meaning of sanlalaya iti by dushtanda shrutya. Yes, shuddham rupam syat pratyagatmanaham. The tika says, shuddha buddhadi yat praticha pratyagatmanas praticha. Shuddham rupam, that means what? Shuddha buddhadi yat praticha rupam tad vivakshitam syat. That is what you have to add there. Tad vivakshitam syat. So by the word sanlalaya, which obtains in the dushtanda or in the illustration, in the dashtanda, what is illustrated, we should understand that it is a shuddha or the pure nature of pratyagatma. The nitya shuddha buddha mukta svabhava pratyagatma is what is meant by. So what is intended or what is indicated by the word sanlalaya? In drishtanta, that nest. In the darshtanta, the nitya shuddha buddha mukta svabhava. That is the praticha shuddham rupam. So that's the pure nature of Pratyekatma. That is what is meant by the sandalaya or the nest. Then, second line of the verse is Pratyekchidabha agatya dhriyate Pratyekatmane. So Pratyekatmane, tasmai Pratyekatmane. Pratyek, so sandalaya, similarly Pratyekatmane. So, for sanlalaya he goes, similarly for pratyagatma, this jivatma goes. So, that's the idea. That's for the fourth case. Now, pratyak chidabha. What is pratyak chidabha? See the tika. Pratyak chid eva bhasamanah samsari. Pratyak chid abha, abhasa. So, what is meant is, one who appears like pratyagatma. That is chidabhasa, the reflected consciousness, which is what we call ahankara or the jiva. So consciousness reflected in the antahkaranam is called chidabhasa. That's the jiva, the ahankara, the samsari. So pratyakchit eva bhasamanah samsari. So one that appears like the pratyakchit, but one who is nothing but the reflected consciousness, that means the consciousness identified with this upadhi is called chidabhasa, samsari. So that is pratyakchidabhasa. Then, pratyek agnyane, sabhase, sopadi buddhi, upadhi, buddhyadi, upasamhare sati. So, just as that bird stretches his wing or withdraws all the avayava into himself, similarly also this chidabhasa or the jivatma withdraws all these limbs into himself. Unto himself is what? Into the avidya. So, pratyek agnyane, svabhase, sabhase. Pratyajnana means what? The self-ignorance. Sabhasa meaning self-ignorance which enjoys the reflection of consciousness. As we said, that ignorance will always enjoy the reflection of consciousness. And therefore, what the products of ignorance also will always enjoy? Reflection of consciousness. So, sabhasa, pratyajnana. So, upadhi buddhyadi upasamhare. So, like withdrawing all the limbs, here also the whole upadhi, buddhi, indriya, sukaryakana, sanghata, all of that is withdrawn in the ignorance, in the causal state, in the deep sleep state. Upasamhare sati. Now what happens to him? What is this chidabhasa? Chidabhasa is nothing but the atma identified with the upadhi. So when the upadhi is now completely withdrawn into the deep, in the ignorance, in the causal state, this he cannot exist independently now. Just as the reflection. So reflection is there as long as the reflecting medium, that is the water, is there. But suppose the water is dries up completely, or the water is removed, then the reflection has no place to go. Where will the reflection go? To its to the image it will go. So the reflected sun, you can say, goes to the sun, that is the image. So that's called bimba, this is called pratibimba. Because reflection cannot obtain independent of the reflecting medium. Similarly also, the jivatma cannot obtain independent of the upadhi. So when the upadhi is completely withdrawn in ignorance with a deep sleep state, then this jivatma also merges into pratyekatma. So, so upadhi buddhyadi upasamhare sati upahitaha. So one that is conditioned, hiruk avasthadam ashaknuvan. Now he cannot, that condition, that reflection cannot remain even for a moment. Similarly also, this jiva, the chidabhasa cannot chit. So chidabhasa is the consciousness reflected in the buddhi. So when the buddhi is a reflecting medium, when that merges into its the causal state, that is ignorance, then the reflected consciousness, chidabhasa cannot remain, the conditioned consciousness cannot remain. So upahita, upahita means condition. Hiruk means hiruk at all, avasthatam ashaknuvan, not being able to now remain in the conditioned state. Bimbasthaniyaya pratyagatmane so atmanam bimbasthaniyaya pratyagatmane agatya. So pratyagatmane, the fourth case. What is pratyagatma? Bimbasthaniya. Bimbasthani means of the nature of the image. So here the sun being reflected in the reflecting medium in the water. That's the imagery. So that's the, this is the pratibimbavada. So Vartikara says that atma can be compared to the sun. Our buddhi or antahkaran can be compared to the water, in the body can be compared to the vessel where the water is contained, and the jivatma, the ahankara, can be compared to the reflected sun. And when the reflecting medium is no more there, the reflection also can no more be there, you can say the reflection runs. Where does it run? Towards the image. So merges into image. So similarly also, bimbasthaniyaya agatya atmanam vibharti. So bimbasthaniyaya paramatmane agatya. That's the verse. Pratyek chidava agatya dhriyate pratyekatmane. Pratyek chidava pratyekatmane agatya atmanam dhriyate. And so this chidabhasa, he comes to pratyekatma and then remains there. Atmanam vibharti means what? He remains in that state, in the deep sleep state. But even though what is meant is deep, what is said is deep sleep state, what is meant is pratyekatma, Shuddha Buddha Svabhava. So that is where the Jivatma merges. Because what is Jivatma? Is nothing but ultimately consciousness. Consciousness merges into consciousness. The Upadhi merges into ignorance. But the Jivatma, samsari, merges into consciousness, Brahma. Now the Tika continues. Uktamartham drishtantena spashtayati. Same thing. What was said in the earlier verse, uktamartham, the meaning that was said, is clarified by drishtanta. Drishtanta that we already gave, in fact. Buddhyadi karya samhare pratyek chaitanya rupinah chidbimbasyabhi samharah jalarka pravilapavat. Buddhyadi karya samhara. Samhara means upasamhara. So buddhyadi karya. Karya means the products of ignorance. So buddhyadi, buddhi, etc., the upadhi, which is the product of ignorance, samhara, upasamhara. So when that is completely folded up in the causal state and deep sleep state, then pratyek chaitanya rupinah chidbimbasyabhi. Then this chidabhasa, which is a reflection, so then tasyabhi samharah. So that reflected consciousness also gets folded up. Jalarka pravilabhavat. Jala means water, arka means sun. So reflected sun, pravilabha. So how the reflected sun also totally merges into the sun. Similarly also, this jivatma merges into pratyagatma. So this is explained by drishtanta of the reflected consciousness. Although Shruti herself gave the drishtanta of the shena or suparana, but then Vartikara gives the common drishtanta of the reflected consciousness. See the tika. So chit bimbasya, chit prasbimbasya diyavata. So pratyek chaitanya rupina chit bimbasya means actually we should understand chit prasbimbasya. Bimba means image, but sometimes bimba also means reflection. So here by the word bimba, in that verse we should understand reflection. Chit bimbasya means reflected consciousness. Then the tika says, jivasya upasamhare bhavatve sati nashitvat. Hey, you are saying that the jivatma upasamhara means the jivatma gets completely folded up. So that upasamhara is bhavatve. Is that upasamhara real? Is the total folding up or the elimination of jivatma, if it is a positive fact that he gets completely eliminated, then janmapisyat. Just as when we say that the river completely merges itself into the ocean, is there a total destruction of river? Or when the reflection gets merged completely into the sun, is it a total destruction of reflection? Or when this chidabhasa or the jivatma merges into Brahman in the state of deep sleep, is there a complete destruction of the atma? If there is destruction of the atma, then there would have to be birth of the atma also. Janma bisyat. What is meant by samhara or upasamhara? What samhara is? Samhara means what? Destruction. Upasamhara means merging. So what is meant by samhara? Does it mean that atma gets destroyed in the state of deep sleep? Then janma apisyat, then there will be birth also. Tatha cha na atma ashrutehe iti adhikarana virodha. Then there will be virodha of this adhikarana. This nyaya in the Brahma Sutra, na atma ashrutehe nityatvacha tabhya. That's a Brahma Sutra. In that Brahma Sutra, what is meant is na atma. Means what? Atma, jivaha, na utpadyate. There is no birth for jiva. Kutaha why? Ashrutehe. Because we never hear the birth or the death of the jiva, meaning atma. उत्पत्ति प्रकरणेशु जीवोत्पत्ते अश्रवणा. सो इन द उपनिषद वेर एवर देयर इज द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ क्रिएशन वी नेवर फाइंड द क्रिएशन ऑफ जीवात्मा. यू ऑलवेज फाइंड क्रिएशन ऑफ उपाधि बट वी नेवर फाइंड क्रिएशन ऑफ जीवात्मा. देयरफॉर देयर इज नो बर्थ फॉर द आत्मा. नित्यत्वाच ताव्य एंड देयर आर श्रुतिज शेष महान अज आत्मा. द आत्मा दिस इज द महान अज आत्मा. दिस उपनिषद इटसेल्फ विल से अजो नित्य शाश्वतोयम पुराण. दिस श्रुति इज वेरी क्लियरली से अज आत्मा इज ऑलवेज मेंशनड एंड दिस एंड मेनी अदर श्रुतिज. सो सबाख्याभ्यंतरो ह्यज. सो देयर आर मेनी श्रुति स्टेटमेंट्स विच डिस्क्राइब आत्मा इज अज इज अनबोर्न एंड देयरफॉर बेस्ड ऑन द श्रुति स्टेटमेंट्स ऑल्सो देयर कैन बी नो बर्थ ऑफ द आत्मा. एट द सेम टाइम we do not find the birth of the Atma being described by the any statement of the Upanishad. Therefore, na Atma ashrutehe. So, nityatva, that is from the Shruti, where the Atma is told to be aja, nityatva avagamat. We find that Atma is nitya. That's what the Shruti means to say. Nitya means avinashi, free from death. That means free from birth also. So, there cannot be birth in a primary sense for the Atma or even Jivatma. Therefore, even a deep sleep state also, there cannot be death in the primary sense. So death here only means jalarka pravilabhavata. It is just as a reflected sun gets merged into the bimba of the sun. Similarly also, the jivatma or the ahankara, who is like the reflected consciousness, merges into its true nature. So, last sentence of Tika, upadhilaya sati upahitasya अनुपहित मात्रत्वेन अवस्थानात् लयोपि न वस्तुतः इत्यर्थः. उपाधि लय द उपाधि गोज अवे उपहित व्हेन कंडीशनिंग एलिमेंट गोज अवे द कंडीशनड वन अनुपहित मात्रत्वेन अवस्थान हि मीन्स इन एन अनकंडीशन स्टेट. सो दिस दैट जस्ट एज द रिफ्लेक्शन इज अवर कंडीशनड सन. And conditioned sun cannot be when the conditioning medium is not there. So when the conditioning medium goes away, like the water in that case, conditioned cannot remain in the conditioned state. Therefore, he obtains in the unconditioned state. That is what is meant by merger. That is what is meant by laya. That is what is meant by samhara and nothing else. Not that there is laya or samhara in the primary state. In short, therefore, the word anta here means अज्ञातम ब्रह्म और प्रत्येक आत्मा नित्य शुद्ध बुद्ध मुक्त स्वभाव है. एंड देयरफॉर बाय द दृष्टांत ऑफ द डीप स्लीप देन द श्रुति रियली वांट्स टू डिलिनिएट एक्सपाउंड द ट्रू नेचर ऑफ द आत्मा दैट इज नित्य शुद्ध बुद्ध मुक्त स्वभाव है. भाष्यकर सेड दैट इज अर्लियर पैसेजेस डिस्क्राइब्ड आत्मास नेचर. सो इन सो मेनी पैसेजेस विद रेफरेंस टू वेकिंग इन द ड्रीम इन द डीप स्लीप स्टेट the nature of the Atma was described as devoid of different from karyakarana sanghata, is also different from kama and the karma, as an asangha and different from avidya also. But now Shruti wants to describe all of that in one passage alone. And therefore this illustration was given. Now we have the page 1091, continuing with Bhashya there. There is now the introduction to next Kandika. Vashyakara wants to now, Vashyakara shows the connection of the following passage, the 20th passage has, with the passage that has gone by. That is what Anandagiri says. Shyena vakyena atmanah saushuptam rupa muktam. Shyena vakyena. So by the previous statements, which give the illustration of Shena, Atmana Saushuptam Rupamuktam. Saushuptam Rupam. The Rupa or the nature that obtains of the Atma in the deep sleep state. What is that? The seventh footnote. Aprapancham Satchidanandekatanam Swabhavikam Rupamuktam. So it is not the purpose to describe deep sleep there. The purpose is to describe, to in fact expound the true nature of the Atma. And what is the true nature of the Atma? When no upadhi remains, how is he? Where he is totally reposed unto himself. where it's totally devoid of any anartha or any kind of pain at all. This ananda is the nature of the atma. So, aprapancham. So, devoid of prapancha. What is prapancha? Karya karana sanghada, kama, karma, avidya, all of this is prapancha. Aprapancham. Satchidananda ekatanam. Ananda ekatanam. Pure ananda. And that ananda which cannot be negated, therefore it is sat ananda. Ananda which is the nature of consciousness, vachidananda. So, satchidananda ekatanam. Svabhavikam rupam. That is a name. That is svabhavikam rupam. So the rupa or the form or the nature of the atma that obtains in waking is not svabhavika. Or obtains in the dream is not svabhavika. What obtains in a deep sleep or an unconditioned state, let us say, is svabhavika. In the waking also, as the next one will describe, even the dream also, if one has recognized one's true nature as devoid of upadhi, then one is in a svabhavika state, even the waking also. But without one's effort, everybody attains that svabhavika or the natural state in the deep sleep. Saushuptam svabhavikam rupam uktam. So that is what was the intention of the previous passage. Idanim, now, in the next passage. Nadi khandasya, nadi khanda. Nadi ghatita vakyasya, tava ityadehe. In short, the next passage beginning with tavai, in which the nadis are being described, you know, very fine nerves are being described, hita. So, there are nerves called the hita, which are so fine that even a hair is split in a thousandfold, thousand way. Imagine that those fine nerves are there, and in those nerves the atma goes at the time of dream. This is the idea here. We'll see that. or let us read that. Read me, open that page 1093, so let us see what it says. So you'll know what Bhashyakara is talking about. Tava asya etaha hitaha nama nadyaha. So, tavai asya, this namaha. These nadis which are called hita. Asya purushasya, of this purusha, of the atma, of this person, these are the nadis. Nadi means a nurse. What is this nadi is a debatable thing, whether these are nadis are the really the veins carrying the blood, no. But then they talk about number, etc., you know. So then they think that they are nerves which carry what we call the current of consciousness, so through which the chetanata or the consciousness is being conveyed to the whole body. So they are called nerves. But then they talk about the size and things like that. So looks like they are in fact some fine material, physical things, where the atma goes. So for atma to go, they should be like tubes, you know. I don't think nerves are tubes, you know. Nerves are also tubes. Microscopic tubes, then it's fine. So if nerves are also tubes, then it's fine. And so, that's microscopic. Yatha keshaha sahasradha bhinnaha. Just as a hair is split diametrically into 1,000 parts. So, 1,000, it's 1,000-fold it is split diametrically. 1,000 means, you know, high number, you know. So, even a hair which itself is so fine that it is split in 1,000-fold, so fine these nerves are there, they are called hita. Tavata animna tishthanti. So these hitar, those fine nerves, there are some crores of them, you know, in the body, supposedly. And these nerves apparently gain different colors. These nerves themselves are transparent, but these nerves gain colors. Shuklasya, neelasya, pingalasya, haritasya, lohitasya, purnaha. These nadya. But at the time of dream, these nadis become filled with different colors. Why shuklasya, neelasya, blue, pingalasya brown, haritasya green, lohitasya red, depending upon the composition of his body. So depending on the kind of the food that he eats, and from that the combination of kapha, vata, pitta that happens, that is how these different colors are found in these nerves, and that is what determines what the dream is going to be. So dream is going to be determined when Atma, Jivatma comes to these nerves at the time in the state of dream. And what is the nature of dream is determined by the colors of these nerves. And these colors themselves are determined by the combination of phlegm and the vayu and the pitta, kapha vata pitta.
And then themselves are determined by the kind of food and whatever that is, you know. So this is how it is. So Lohitasya Purna. This is what it is. So in short, this is the abode, or this is a place where he comes during the dream state. That's the idea. In the waking state, the Atma is in one kind of nerves. In the dream state, the Atma is in different nerves. In the deep sleep state, he is in yet different nerves. That is why these three abodes are there. Then now it says, at asa yatrainam granti iva. Now in the dream he gains various experiences, as though somebody is killing him. So all kinds of papa that is performed, you know, that gives rise to this kind of experiences in the dream, you know. So he's being killed by somebody. Jinanti iva. So he is being overpowered by people, you know. That's what he finds. Hastiva vichayati. He's being chased by an elephant. Gartam eva patati. He falls in a pit, you know. So all kinds of things. In short, these kind of experiences that he has. Yadeva jagrat bhayam pashyat. In short, whatever kind of fearful experience or frightful experience he had in a waking state, he sees those things in the dream. Understand, that is ignorance. So tadatra avidya manyate. So when these kind of experiences are there in the dream, which experiences are nothing but the carryover from the waking, which waking experiences are in the involved fear, and that fear is nothing but a product of ignorance. So because of ignorance, in the waking state he has fear. And that fear is carried on into the dream state by way of samskara, and that fear creates those scenes then, you know. So fear is what he experiences in the waking, and that fear he recreates. How do you recreate fear? By recreating fearful events. How do you recreate jealousy? By recreating events in, you know, that reflect jealousy. So the specific events that are created in a dream reflect the various kinds of emotions that he has, you know. So anyway, so out of fear, all these kind of experiences he gains. So tatra avidya manyate, this is called ignorance. So the products of ignorance. So this is what ignorance does. In short, this nadi vakya is meant to describe ignorance or the products of ignorance. That there is a direct, immediate experience of ignorance. Asayatra devaha eva, raja eva, ahameva idam sarva sarvosmiti manyate. Or he finds himself to be God. He finds himself to be a king or a sovereign. Or ahameva idam. So I am Brahman, sarvaham, sarvoham, I am the self of all. So that kind of dream when he has, sahasya paramolokaha, that is the paramolokaha, that is the highest abode, highest world, highest state. That means that shows he is liberated. That means that the samskara of moksha in the waking state, they give rise to this, the samskara of moksha in the experience of moksha in the dream state also. So this kandika describes the dream state. Thereby, and then subsequent kandikas. So idea of this kandika is to describe ignorance and the nature of ignorance and the products of ignorance. That's what Bhashyakara says, you know. So from this passage, to draw those conclusions really requires something, from these passages of Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. To be able to see these profound truths of life must really require some kind of a mind. There's no way that anybody reading these passages can arrive at this thing, you know. So when we read this passage, what will you conclude, you know? You think there is some description of nadi and things like that? But then, so let us see what Bhashyakara has to say. So Bhashyakara shows the sambandha or the connection that this particular kandika has with the previous kandika. Now go back to page 1091. As Anandagiri said, Shena Vakyena Atmanaha Saushuptam Rupamuktam. So, Nitya Shuddha Buddha Maksvahav, the Atma, was stated in the previous kandika. Idanim Nadi Khandasya Sambandham. So, Nadi Khanda means this khanda, this section which involves Nadi. So, Nadi Ghatida Vakyasya, that kandika of which Nadi is one of the elements. Tava Ityadehe. So, Sambandham Puru Granthena Sambandham Vaktum. What relationship that passage has with the preceding section, Vaktum? Chodayati asks the question. So in order to show the sambandha, the connection that the following passage has with the previous section, he, Vashyakara, raises a question in order to show what that relation is. So there is Akansha Sangati, different kinds of Sangati are there. So let us say that the previous passage raises some questions, and then the subsequent passage is in answer to that question. That's called Akansha, Akansha Sangati. So read the Bhashya. Yadi asya ayam svabhavah sarva samsara dharma shunyata paropadhi nimittam cha asya samsara dharmitvam yan nimittam cha asya paropadhikritam samsara dharmitvam sacha avidya. All part of the question. Yadi asya ayam svabhavah. Footnote 5, asya atmanah ayam svabhavah. Of this atma, this is the nature. What's the nature? Sarva samsara dharma shunyata. If this is the nature of the atma, that is devoid of all the samsara dharma. Samsara dharma is karyakana sanghata, identification with karyakana sanghata. Samsara dharma is kama, samsara dharma is karma, which is a product of avidya. That atma is devoid of avidya, kama, karma, which is mrityu, and the karyakana sanghata is mrityu ho rupani. So if atma is devoid of all the samsara dharma, sarva samsara dharma shunyata, I am svabhava atmanah, then what's the nature, what is it that makes him samsari? Paropadhi nimittam cha asya samsara dharmitvam. That atma appears to be possessed of samsara dharma, possessed of the attributes of samsara because of upadhi. Paropadhi. See the next page, Anandika says, parahasan upadhi buddhyadhi. One reef must be there, I think. So paropadhi. So parasan upadhi. So that which is paraha as well as upadhi is called paropadhi. It's buddhyadhi. So paropadhi nimittam, buddhyadhi nimittam. So that which is para means different, anatma, as well as that is upadhi, this buddhyadhi, buddhi etc., which is upadhi. So tan nimittam samsara dharmitvam, that atma himself is sarva samsara dharma varjitaha, and tasya samsaritvam buddhyadhi upadhi nimittam, if this is so. Then Anandagiri says, asangatvataha svataha buddhyadi sambandha asambham upaityaha. And also, the samsara is due to the association of buddhi, but atma cannot have a real association or connection with buddhi. It's only going to be like crystal. That the color in the crystal is due to upadhi, para upadhi, namely some flower, etc. And that too, there is no real connection that the crystal has with flower, because crystal is always clear. Similarly also the samsaritvam, that is there in the atma, is due to the buddhi, the conditioning element. But then, the relation that the atma cannot have any relation to buddhi, because atma is always unrelated, asangaha. So asangatvataha, on account of asangatva, svataha buddhyadi sambandha asambhavam, that atma cannot have really a sambandha or the association with buddhi, etc. In upetyaha, yannimittam cha bhashyakara said, yannimittam cha asya paropadhikratam samsara dharmitvam. And that the samsara dharmitvam of the atma, which is due to upadhi, also has a nimitta. Even upadhi also cannot bring about samsara. The idea is that even the upadhi cannot bring about samsara. That karyakana sangata is there, even karma is there, even kama is there. Even they also cannot bring about samsara. But they are able to bring about the samsara in atma because avidya is there. So vikshepa is not only vikshepa is not samsara, avaranam also is required. Avaran and vikshepa together become samsara. Avaran is not knowing the true nature of the self. Vikshepa is superimposing what the self is not. So not knowing the true nature of Rajju and superimposing snake there, avaran and vikshepa. So similarly, that vikshepa itself need not create samsara. For example, when I see mirage water, there is vikshepa. I see the mirage water, which is a projection. But if I know that it is mirage water, it doesn't cause any problem to me. When I do not know the true nature of that, like an animal, think that is real water and runs towards it and then suffers. So, knowing vikshepa alone cannot cause with samsara. Vikshepa in conjunction with avarana causes samsara. So this paropadi nimittam samsara dharmitvam, that atma is possessed of the karyakana sanghata and the kama and the karma and all of that, is due to the upadi, namely, that is called sahaja tadatma. So as long as upadi is there, so long the association of atma with upadi will be there, sahaja tadatma. As long as body is there, some kind of an association with the body will be there. And as long as one functions through the upadi, some kind of an association is going to be there. But that is not the problem. Bhrantijam tadatmyam. That ignorance causes the identification of upadi. So that is the samsara. That is avidya. Samsara dharitvam sacha avidya. So merely karyakara sanghada, the gross and subtle body being there, or the mind being there, even the actions are there, even the desires are there. Even if all of these things are there, one need not be a samsari. Only when there is the purusha prakritistha, when there is identification prakriti, then karanam guna sangosya, then there is aham bhava in the guna, and that is how the janma happens. So Vashyakara says here, since atma himself asangohyam purusha, atma on his own is asanga or unattached, therefore he cannot have any connection to upadhi, and silly things is connected with them, that is due to ignorance. So the connection of upadhi is brought about by ignorance. So yan nimittam cha asya paropadikritam samsara dharmitvam sacha avidya. So that also is avidya that brings about the sangha or the identification of the upadhi.